Hello, my name is Steve Bigelow with the Candlestick Forum. Reading candlestick charts makes your trading profitability tremendously better knowing what the signals and patterns are illustrating. Step one, again, is what is the general direction of the market? Obviously down. And we can see the type of patterns that are created on the way down, bearish J-hook patterns, which we know wave one, wave two, wave three is going to be the same magnitude as wave one. Just as we saw here, wave one, wave two, wave three was the same magnitude as wave one. This allows for much more aggressive and quicker trading setups, knowing what the general direction of the market is. And that's not all based upon the Dow. You can recognize where the strong selling has been coming into the NASDAQ. There's your bearish best friend. Wave one, wave two, wave three. Wave one, wave two. Now a strong bearish best friend signal trading to the downside. And another little facet that everybody was paying attention to today was the fact that NASDAQ closed just below the low of here and the low of the last, I think they said 2 years. So looks like it could still go lower since it didn't support at this level. So that allows us to take advantage of the power trades. 2+2 analysis. If you see a bearish J-hook and a bearish best friend, the probabilities are pretty strong you're heading lower. Now, the other side of that coin is you want to be able to evaluate the probabilities. It had kind of a gap down in Yeti on Friday, but notice what it did today. Did a doji, basically supporting at this level. That tells you immediately that the probabilities are going against you. So you can immediately make your trading strategy, which would be, if this opens positive tomorrow, you close out the position. The benefit of the graphics of candlesticks is it allows you to make decisions immediately based upon what we know about investor sentiment. The fact that the uptrend saw on Friday where they gapped down below the previous day's open, which is obviously a very strong bearish indication, which makes the trading strategy simple. If you see it gap down below the previous day's open during an uptrend and stochastic's rolling over, close it out immediately. The second alert would be that if you held on to this until it closed below the T line, the fact that it closed below the T line dramatically changed the probabilities of this uptrend. You definitely close it there. Why? Because you can get caught in these type of situations. The worst case scenario is you close it here, it does a J hook, you can always buy it back. But knowing what the alerts are, because of the graphics, the candlestick analysis, gets you out of bad trades quickly or allows you to take profits when it's time to take profits. So there are times where you don't worry about closing below the T line. If we know what our expectations are, that this should have been a 45 degree, and the fact that they close back below the lows of this doji, what would your expectations be? They're probably coming back to test the T line. Now, is that feasible? Yes, we also know the market is heading down. So there's probably not a lot of bullish sentiment in what was perceived as being a 45 degree to the upside. Close out the trade when the probabilities are going against you. You can always buy back if the things turn around. So what we're looking for when we're reading candlestick charts is, what trend are we in and what are strong sell signals, like your bearish flutter kicker signal? You could be shorting with a high degree of probability that this trend is still in a downtrend. Same thing right here with Daku. There's there was your alert right there that if you had gone long, you're back out of the trade because it opened and closed below the previous day's open, which is not a good bullish indication, number one. And number two, it closed below the T line. So number three, it's telling you if this opens lower the next day, you've got a bearish kicker signal in progress. You can be shorting this one. What confirmed this downtrend? That could be perceived as a support level. Gap down through there, what are we looking at? Wave one, wave two, and a strong sell signal starting wave three. The more we can put into our analysis that the downtrend is in progress, like a failure at the 50, your bearish best friend, gap down below the T line, you can stay short. What's your observations? If it breaks down through this level, we got wave one, wave two, wave three. This is basically the analysis of high probability trade setups using the results of human nature that show you when there's a strong selling force, when resistance or support levels are broken, and what the patterns are likely to be. Again, the more pieces of evidence that we can put into our analysis, like a failure right smack dab at the 50 with a doji, bearish best friend, and now they haven't supported at this level, probabilities tell us we've got an extremely good short trade now that it didn't support after a strong sell signal. So knowing what this information conveys for us allows you to take advantage of good short trades quickly, that you don't have to sit and wait for confirmation. You know what should confirm those trades. This is the type of thing we teach in our chat rooms every day and on Monday and Thursday nights. This information doesn't necessarily coincide with fundamental analysis. Prices move not because of fundamentals, but the perception of fundamentals, and the graphics of candlesticks are merely the graphic depiction of investor sentiment. So join us. Try our 2-week free trial. We have chat rooms going every day where you learn a heck of a lot of good trades, good trade setups, and you learn candlestick analysis much more expeditiously than trying to learn it on your own. Just email abraham@candlestickforum.com. Say I'd like to try the 2-week free trial. That'll be it. We'll see you in the chat rooms.